Hey everybody, welcome to another podcast, Hope you can join me with every single day that a podcast will happen, every single day. Folks, my name, I'm going to go by a new name. I'm going to go by the name of Dave Podcast. Yes, it's Dave Podcast. No more Dave Nation Podcast. It'll be, and here and out, it's going to be Dave Podcast. Dave's Podcast, okay? Dave's Podcast. That's simple as that. So, moving forward from Dave's podcast, this is going to be a podcast, but it's going to be Dave's podcast. So that in mind, we're going to move forward. We're going to talk about a tragedy. Now, this is not ordinary tragedy. There's many tragedies in life, in our human aspect. Now, this young girl, age 19, now I'm going to mention her name right here for you folks. There's been many videos, many surveillance video footage, and tons of people weighing in on all this. And I mean weighing in on all this. Folks, you don't need to hear from me. I said from the last video, there was this 19-year-old girl, this was around the 2017 year. This is close to about, what, 4 years ago? Close to 4 years ago, coming up this September. Now, they said in the videos, it was September of 2017. Sometime around there, I think the 9th of, the 9th, the 10th, surveillance cameras show otherwise. Anyway, we don't know the actual date, but anyway, we're assuming that's either the 8th, 9th, or 10th of September of that day. It could be three of those days. It could have a matter of hours, minutes, or seconds, days. This is just a tragedy, okay? We're just going to call the way it is. I don't want to go into great depth about this, but I will say this. There's theories. People say on their titles, theories to clues, to more clues, to hearsay, to the surveillance footage, to the hotel, to everything, folks. We are talking about a girl who's 19 years old, went to a party, and you know how people like to do in parties and stuff. Yeah, drinking, you know, drugs and stuff like that. But anyway, I don't want to talk about that sort of parties. Parties can only mean good things or bad things. Parties can mean good things, you've been around with a lot of friends. Parties can mean you've been around with a lot of friends that you really appreciate, that you want to hang out with. Now, I'm going to mention her name right here the very first time on this podcast. She goes by the name of Caitlin Jenkins, or Caitlin Jenkins, as far as I know. I hope I'm saying her name properly. I'm trying to remember her name right now because I'm trying to figure out what her name was. Camila Jenkins, I think that's her name. Anyway, I'll put in the title for you folks. A lot of people said their theories. Everybody said there are more clues to the hotel footage. This is surveillance footage. People had tons and tons of surveillance footage. 36 hours of surveillance footage. All the way around, inside the hotel and outside of the hotel. The mother of the daughter, who I mentioned the name to, didn't go back there. I don't know why, but anyway, the whole hotel, essentially the whole hotel is kind of like suspect. It's kind of, I'll give you this much, people. The people that were there inside this hotel, they were subjects. They're kind of like suspects and stuff like that. They're just, what's the good terminology would you say? They're all suspect, to prove it is guilty, as they say. But you know, in this day and age, you just never know. I'll just say this much. If I was the people who has to investigate this investigation, they should investigate everybody who was there at the hotel. The people that were in the hotel, the people that were everything. Everybody in that whole hotel should be investigated about her death. I mean, everybody in that hotel in 2017. Now, I'm not going to mention the hotel's name, so it could be any hotel. So I'm just going to say it's a hotel. I'm not going to give you where it is. I don't want anybody going there. I will say this. There's been a lot of clues, a lot of theories about way it was handled, way it was handled. Even the mother said a whole bunch of stuff about it. She had a, by the way, she had a sister, by the way, in case you're wondering. Yes, she had a sister. But this whole theory's a running rampant. Everybody's on YouTube saying their points of view, and about way, you know what, thank God, I do mean thank God or thank Jesus or Lord and Savior, that in this day and age we have so-called surveillance cameras in these business places, in hotels and you name it. Thank God, surveillance cameras. If it weren't for surveillance cameras, the mother of this daughter will never know if she's all right and everything. But yeah, if it weren't for the surveillance footage, folks, Rishi, with today's technology today, cameras can see all. Did I say all? On the footage. Once you push the record button on the camera and the camera keeps rolling, even with the surveillance cameras today, they're continuous recording. They're recording continuously. They don't stop for hours and hours and hours. They do have settings. Yes, they do have settings. But cameras, surveillance cameras are like night and day. They record everything continuously. So it's hard to spot people inside a business place, like a hotel or a business place, to really capture what you just saw on the footage. Folks, I just want to say we're blessed in this day and age. Sometimes surveillance cameras help us and don't help us. But the surveillance footage really helps us when there's somebody who either, I'm not going to mention here, folks, because there's been a lot of speculations on videos on YouTube about what led to her, you know, I'm not going to say it here, to her last moments, her last breath, her last words. What I'm going to say to all you folks out there, and there's videos, there's tons of videos since 2017? Folks, it's been 4 years, and I just caught on to it like a few days ago. This is another young girl who come to her, not really demise, but the whole speculation. Her mother is upset. She had a sister. The people that were at the party, she was around with people who had parties, you know, and went to a hotel, big party, and drank, and had a lot of pills and stuff. And by the way, so folks, like I said, you got to be careful of these parties. Sometimes you can be parties with friends that you know you really care about. But this lady had her demise and stuff like that. So folks, bear this in mind. I'm not going to run theories here. All I'm going to say, folks, is one of the YouTube videos were saying new clues, breaking news. They're going all these theories about this young girl who had demise, did it really pass away in so-called freezer theory. And so like I said, folks, I'm going to mention her name on the big title. I'm going to say update to this very, it's been 4 years since 2017, folks. People do have parties, don't question about it. People have parties from the 70s and 80s. And 2000s, and I just like to say that this girl came to her demise. It's really sad having tragedies like this. There's many tragedies in the world that you can hope for. This is one of them. This is really sad. Even the mother is speaking out about all this. Speaking out from this. So, like I said, folks, we are doing the best that we can. So I'm going to mention her name in the big title, make it an update. This will be an update video. Not really a video, but a podcast about this young girl who's age 19, far as I heard about it, September of 09, 08, or 010 of September 2017. The surveillance footage did show the time and stamp and the year. It was raw footage from the surveillance camera footage. Sometimes hotels do have surveillance cameras inside and out of the areas. But I'm not going to mention the hotel's name because I don't want people go there and speculate how it didn't happen. It could be any hotel around the world. But anyway, like I said, this only happened in 2017. So this girl had her long demise. There, people are trying to analyze these surveillance footage. This whole, apparently I'm hearing it's 36 hours of footage seeing her on the cameras, on the surveillance cameras. Thank God for surveillance cameras, eh? Always thanks God for the surveillance cameras. But yeah, I think she just, had a tragic end to herself. And I mean, this is really sad for a lot of those people out there. But yeah, they had a little party sometimes in parties. They have too much drink, too much pills taken. Anyway, I don't want to be a stigma to this, folks. You got to be careful when people are at parties. Just be careful when you're people at parties. People are trying to analyze those surveillance footage. I mean, I don't know how much more you can see surveillance footage. I was trying to figure out what led to all this. I'm trying to get clues on all these videos that I'm seeing here. It's really hard to comprehend. I think everybody should be a suspect. I mean, everybody in the hotel at that time in 2017 should have been a suspect to this young girl, her life, actually. I really, really speculated, though, because I was just thinking when I was seeing the surveillance footage, I mean, they had the cameras all inside the hotel, not in the rooms or anything, just outside, not really outside, but inside the hotel. These surveillance cameras, you probably will see them in the hotels when you go into hotels, people. They're mounted way up there, and when they walk the hallways of the hotels and stuff, yes, they truly see you from the surveillance cameras. And they do put them in there for certain reasons. I thank God for the surveillance cameras. They're like 24 hours a day, night and day cameras. They're on they call it continuous recording. Surveillance cameras are usually night and day cameras. So they can handle the day and night. They have, so surveillance cameras usually go for long periods of time and then a continuous recording. So that means they're not like a loop, it just continuous recording until the 24 hours is up kind of thing. But yeah, it's continuous recording, night and day camera, surveillance cameras are like night and day cameras. They can see everything. People come in and out in hotels, everything else. But anyway, yeah, so I'm sorry to take up all your time. I'm sorry about this girl's, passing and, the mother of that young lady who was 19 years old, according to what I was hearing, was 19 years old. But she has been alive today. She would have been, 23 years old at the moment? So she's kind of being an adult. She would have been that adult age of her ripe age of 23. But anyway, this all happened in 2017. According to what I'm hearing in these videos on YouTube, apparently it happened in September of 2017. Around, I think the day was about 08 and 09 and 010, according to the surveillance footage. They looked at it. A lot of those people in the hotel, they looked at the surveillance footage. Thank God for that, folks. Anyway, this will be an update, my update, my thoughts, my final thoughts, all of this person who I mentioned at the beginning of this podcast. This is Dave's podcast. And hope you enjoyed this podcast of today. And it's going to be Dave's podcast for here on out. And like I said, folks, people have really, 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 really grasped at this. But I won't mention her name. I won't mention the hotel that she was at. I won't do that for you guys, folks. You're just going to have to find out on YouTube videos what hotel she's been at. But like I said, folks, this is just an update. When I looked at the YouTube videos, I'm kind of like a person from looking in sort of videos. So I'm looking out from the videos that I see and into their world, essentially. How do you say into their world? Whatever world. It's just one video says it's a tragedy. It is a tragedy. Nonetheless, it was a tragedy of this young girl of 19 years old. I will mention her name on the big title, on the subtitle. Just to give it recognition and some little closures. They call it closures when people passed away or just rest in peace. Whatever. little closures. People like closures in this world. It's really hard to do closures when your best friend has passed away. My best friend has passed away. I mentioned several videos on that one. This young girl passed away with her friend. I think one of her friends is kind of strung over the whole thing. We have friends of ours who passed away many, many, many times. Many, many times. Many times. These are through different circumstances. And not always people get shot at or knifed at and then die after. Sometimes it's not always a case like that. Maybe it's just from the hotel they were at and they were drunk, and then all of a sudden, tragedy may seem, it's the last few hours before they were passed away. A lot of people thought that she was drunk. Now, they said on a few of the videos they thought she was intoxicated, she was drunk. A lot of, they call it labeling. They call what these people labeling. And clearly you saw in the surveillance footage that she was totally tipsy-topsy, what do you call it, tipsy-topsy, walking weird. It's not like normal people would walk. I'm just saying for everybody out there, I don't highly recommend to go to parties. And just be careful when you guys are at parties nowadays, You don't want to end up like this girl did. It ended her life. It really did. It really sad, really ended her life. And it just sad all around, folks. So I won't tell you about her name, but I won't tell you the hotel she's been at. What I will tell is I will tell you guys that. Hope you guys will be safe and well. And stay safe, as people would say in YouTube videos, stay safe. And don't stay home. Don't stay home, folks. Go out there, do something. Everybody's not in quarantine. I don't want to make everybody be in quarantine. Nobody's in quarantine. No one will be in quarantine unless an asteroid were to hit this planet. Nobody's in quarantine. 2 months isn't bad enough. They're going to open up the cities, the states. And I'm really happy that you people came to realization. So, yeah, this is going to be a story about this young girl's life. I want to really, her mother was on TV shows and stuff like that. Really, really, I don't know if it was sad for her, but, one of her daughters have saw her demise, I guess. But anyway, so, folks, there was theories over this, and I won't tell you about the theories, but yeah, the tragedy, clues, and people were looking at the surveillance footage, and apparently it was 36 hours, like I said on the earlier there. Anyway, this is just an update, and I want to go any further than this. A lot of people chimed in about this young girl who tragically lost her life in the whole world. Sad as to me to see it, age 19, can you believe that? Just 1 year of being an adult. This is at her age being an adult at 19, can you believe this? This is when you don't need your parents and stuff. But yeah, nonetheless, there was the whole entire thing is crazy enough. Anyway, I'm not trying to laugh at this. I'm just saying, you folks, be careful out there. Don't do what this young girl who lost her life of this tragedy, and just be careful at parties and stuff, folks. I'm going to really, really tell her name, say her name, but put her name on this update. This will be an update, folks. Other than that, it's an update. So bear with me, folks, an update. This is from my perspective. It's what I see from the out, from the in. So I'm looking out, and I'm looking into the YouTube videos. And trying to figure out, I'm trying to make heads or tails with these videos. What heads or tails, and what the clues I found out in these videos and stuff. It blows my mind with YouTubers these days. It just really is. But the tragedy, this young girl lost her life, and it's just really, really ridiculous. Anyway, the mother of this tragic end of this girl, speaking out on it, apparently, that's sad all around. This will essentially be my final thoughts on it. I like to do that for everybody, and it's like a closure for everybody who's involved with this crazy tragedy that it had to end that way. But yeah, so folks, it really did. Anyway, just bring closure the best way I can, folks. I'm gonna make this really easier for everybody, and it's hard for me not really criticize anybody. I don't want to criticize anybody about this. It's just a tragic thing that happened to this little girl. Anyway, nonetheless, for everybody, thank you. This is Dave's podcast signing off for now, guys. See you on the next podcast.